In this lesson, we're going to go over the steps for preparing your meshes and exporting them to Unreal. So let's get started. The first thing that I do before starting to model at all is to make sure that I have my units set in a one-to-one configuration with Unreal. Unreal has its units set up in centimeters. So in Maya, you can set it up in centimeters in a couple different ways. I just go under display, and I set my grid for 1,000, 1,000, and subdivision set to 10. So that's all set. The other thing, we're going to talk a little bit more in a later set of videos on naming conventions. When I name my meshes, I put SM underscore as a prefix and then the name of the object. And that stands for static mesh. So the first thing that I want to talk about is setting the pivot point. And the pivot point, when you're outputting, is set by the origin. So in this case, I'm going to switch to wireframe mode. And in wireframe mode, you can see the origin a little bit. Let me just hide this ground plane. It's right there. So now you can put the pivot point depending on how you want to build your objects. So in this case, this is going to be, you know, if it was potentially tileable, putting the pivot point on a corner like that could be really useful. If it was something that was going to rotate, I might want to have the pivot point right in the center of that object. We can talk about that in a future set of videos. But in this case, that's all set. The other thing that you can do too is you can zero out your transforms. So I'm going to freeze the transforms on these objects. And once you've done that and you want to keep working, you can either put them in a layer, hide that layer. The other thing that you can do is you can move the object. When you're ready to export, you can zero out your transforms. Or depending on what package you're using, Autodesk Maya, 3ds Max, Blender, Modo, they have various export plugins that sometimes even automate further. Autodesk Maya and 3ds Max have a game exporter, which automates some of the functionality of zeroing out the objects as you export them. Okay, let's go back into lit mode. So we've talked about setting up the pivot point. The next step would be triangulation. So for Maya, under Mesh Triangulate, you can triangulate in Maya. You can also triangulate as you're exporting, so in the FBX options, or you can just export it and Unreal will triangulate your meshes as you import them. The main reason that some people do on very complex hero meshes that are, you know, they have a lot of polygons, sometimes you want to see the way the polygons triangulate. And why are they triangulated? Well, they're triangulated because the GPU actually works in triangles. You're making it native to the way the GPU would be working. Much of modeling is often taught in quads, but the GPU actually processes in triangles. In addition, then you can set up your UV coordinates, and you can even have multiple UV sets that will export. In this case, I just put in automatic mapping for example purposes. All right. The next step I had was smoothing groups. Now, typically I will not use smoothing groups, especially if I'm using normal maps. Smoothing groups can fight normal maps because they are adjusting the surface normal, which is exactly what normal maps will do. So if I'm going to have normal maps on the object, usually I won't have smoothing groups. But if I'm going to have just this object, in this case I'm not going to have a normal map, then maybe smoothing groups is something I'd want to do. In Autodesk Maya, it's by selecting edges, you can go to soften and harden edges. In this case, I was hardening the edge. So you can see that edge I just hardened. So I just hardened that, unhardened that edge. And when I export that, those hardened and soft edges will come into the engine. We can take a look at that. All right, the next step is setting up the material IDs, and they are based on selections and applications of polygroups. So in this case, you can see I have selected these faces in here and applied a material. And that material I've called M Tunnel Interior. That's also a naming convention. And also the gray is M concrete. Same thing with this object. I've selected these polygons and applied a material to these polygons. Some programs actually have a material ID interface, which is really nice. 3ds Max, and I think Blender also has that option. In this case, I'll just I'll demonstrate. Let's put on a material there for that road. So there we go. We've just applied a black top. So now we've got a road. If we wanted to, we could set up an LOD system as well. In the resources section, I'll point out to a video on how to do LOD groups. For now, I'm just going to export these meshes. Let's zero out the transforms. Select these meshes. We can export them all at once. I'll show different ways of doing this. But you can go File, Export. You can export all or export just the selection. And I wanted to specifically go over some of the options in FBX. Now, the first thing that I wanted to re-emphasize is the FBX file format version. Now, Unreal right now is at FBX 2018. So this is safe, but sometimes you might have FBX 2020 and Unreal only right now as of 2020 supports FBX 2018. Okay. So one thing that is by default on is smoothing groups, so that will detect hardened and softened wireframes. Finally, if we wanted to, we could triangulate here, but in general, we're all set. So let's just give it a name. So we have exported, and we can go over importing in our next video.